We're going to have a quick tour of Shortcuts Lot, or Scowl 5 is often referred to. This is the icon down here on the left with the little scissors and the number 5 designating that it's Shortcuts Lot 5. We double click that and it opens up. Now you can have this shape store or cutters market come up as an option. This you can turn off. So down here on the left, you can go don't show again and just click that and it won't come up each time. Or you can leave it unchecked and it will come up. Or you can go into the open store and have a little browse around and see what's available for purchasing. It's basically shapes and objects that you can add to your Shortcuts a Lot software program for creating other projects from. And then you just click close when you've finished. This next screen is a normal screen that will come up each time. And it gives you the option of creating a new project, open an existing project, or recovered projects. So if you have a crash or something, it will recover it. So these are some of the recent projects I've been working on. And you can see I can just click into any of these and open them up again. So it's a shortcut to opening a recent project. But today we're going to start a new project, which is the top one. And it will give you some options. You can place a name in here. Just type a name and call it, we'll just call it test today because I can't think of anything else. It'll give you a drop down for various size canvases or mats that you can design on. So I often use the 12 by 12 inch. But there's 12 by 24, 24 by 24, which is no good for many of the home cutting machines like the Cricut and the Scan and Cut. These are more designed for more commercial cutting machines or larger cutting machines. 8.5 by 11, A3 once again is quite big, and A4, you can use H4. There is a custom size as well, so you can go in and put your own sizing in if you want the design to be a set size. I will just go with 12 by 12 today. You can also adjust it here if you want to and change the sizing, make it 11 or 12. It's up to you, whatever suits your personal preference for the design, particular design you're creating. You can also change it to a vertical or landscape, either one of these. Obviously 12 by 12 is not ideal to change it to, but if you chose 8.5 by 11, that would make a difference whether you turned it portrait or horizontal. So you can see that would make a difference, but 12 by 12 doesn't really make a difference. And you can select your units. So you can either choose inches, millimetres or centimetres. I often work in inches, sometimes millimetres, just depends on, I don't know, it might be my mood, I'm not really sure. What's ever easiest at the time for what I'm designing. It's perhaps where I change around. It's good to be flexible, I guess. And you just go OK. And this is what you're presented with. Possibly looks a little complicated when you first open it up, but realistically, it's a very easy software program to learn. I really like this program. I use a lot of different programs. This one's very, very reliable is probably the word for it. There's an odd glitch with it sometimes. Sometimes have the undo that doesn't undo properly, and you just close out of it and come back in. It's a bit of a nuisance, but that only happens very occasionally. Okay, so we've got a number of menus. So we've got the top menus that you can see. And then these icons here are also included in the top menus in many ways. So there's your new project. When you drop this down, you can see new project there. You can see there's import and export, they're very handy. Save project as, and trace an image. So trace an image is here as well. Share and get shapes. Print setup. Open existing project, save your project. So if you're moving along, you can just click up here and save it. copy and paste. There's command lines you can use for that too. The library is very handy. That's in the up here as well. Sorry, window, library. The store will take you back to that cutter's store. Preview and the cutter. Down on this left one is your selection tool. This is the one you'll use mostly. It's the one that works most objects. Don't use this one very much. This one's your nodes or shape tool, so you can find the nodes in a program. Cover that. Text tool, your draw tool, it's very handy. Freehand, paintbrush. This little one here is an eraser or a rubber. Took me a long time to actually work out that that was there. I don't know why it took me so long. But that is actually quite a fun thing to fix things. Shapes, a colour dropper, so pipette, sometimes referred to. Gradient for more. If you're not using it for cutting, for more of a design tool, I often use this as a design software for printables as well. So I do some things for printables in it. I don't really create the printables in there. But for example, I pull in designs that perhaps need colouring or altering the colour, and I'll fix them up in here. That's quite handy for that. Knife tool and distort to make some changes. This one here, the zoom tool, is very useful. Ruler and then a little hand to move around. Over to the right, you'll see this is the mat that we're using, or the canvas that we're using here. And you can change it if you want to here. You know, we select it on the way in, but if we wanted to change it now, it will, right now, very easily. It's very flexible software. You can show your grid or not. I sometimes take snapshots without the grid there. You can change your grid lines if you want to. You can have guidelines and no guidelines. Guides are more like a sizing, helps with sizing. And then you have some other ones here as well. Also got the layers panel. There are no layers at the moment, so we haven't got much in there. And then on here, you can also change to different views here. So because there's nothing on the canvas, nothing showing here. But if we add a shape, there we go, we've got a shape. You can see the placement, the XY axis for the placement. I'll just go into, I've changed up to the selection tool. And you can move that shape and you'll see the XY axis changes. Nudge, I love nudge. The alignment tools, I can change the sizing, rotate, colors of the stroke, colors of the fill. You can change the end point of a node, which is more not really a cutting machine, it's more a graphical design feature, I suppose. In my head anyway, I suppose it may be used for other things. Line style, you can get your dashed. And you can change to a draw line if you want to. And then your fonts. Yeah. We also have the ability to create a new project. So you can work on multiple projects at once. Just create that, and now we're in the new screen. We haven't given it a name. Perhaps should have given it a name. Here, I'll create another one and call it, Funky Chook. It'll be very obvious that that's the, and you can see Funky Chook. Test and Funky Chook. There we go. Okay. I'll see you in the next video.